In what may be a sign of things to come in this country, the number of new COVID cases in the United Kingdom is the highest so far during the pandemic. The daily tally was more than 78,000 yesterday. And France now refuses to allow anyone, vaccinated or not, to enter from England without what they're calling a compelling reason. Business or tourism are no longer enough. Holly Williams is tracking the British government's response.
The British Prime Minister, Boris Johnson, couldn't make his message any clearer. It's even written on his podium.
So let's keep going, let's keep giving Omicron both barrels, and let's slow its spread and give the vaccines more time.
And people here are heeding the call, flocking to vaccination clinics, including this one, staffed by the army inside a historic cathedral. On Tuesday, the UK gave a record number of COVID vaccines. Nearly half of all adults in this country have now had their booster shot. Professor Chris Whitty, he's England's Dr. Fauci, acknowledged that hospitalisation rates are still flat, but warned that could change.
This is a really serious threat at the moment. How big a threat? There are several things we don't know, but all the things that we do know are bad.
He also told people to cut back on socialising this holiday season. Since the government here ended virtually all COVID restrictions back in July, business has been booming. There are fears that recovery could now wither. But at vaccine centres, with long lines in the biting cold, we found most people upbeat, despite the terrible warnings.
We all get a booster jab, you know. Everyone, you know, get back to normal days, go back to work, go back to universities, travel, whatever.
And we're just hearing this morning that the Queen has reportedly cancelled the royal family's traditional pre-Christmas lunch for the second year in a row. It's apparently a precautionary step. Gayle.
Everybody's taking precautionary steps, including the Queen. Thank you very much. Holly Williams reporting from London.